Hello everyone, how's everyone doing today? How's everyone doing on this beautiful Saturday afternoon? I hope everybody's having a wonderful weekend so far. So some time ago, I decided that I was going to have a series of videos related to my vocal cord struggles, my decision to have surgery, and the recovery afterwards. So there's a few things that I still need to talk about. For those of you out there who are going through something similar, who are looking for information about what it feels like to have vocal cord polyps or nodules, that are thinking about having surgery or want to know about what the recovery is like. Today, we're going to talk a little more about what that recovery was like for me. So this is in the hopes of if you are trying to make a decision and you're basing a lot on the recovery afterwards, that this will help you make that decision. I know for me, trying to find out as much as possible about what it would be like after the surgery was an important step in making that decision as well. So basically, what I want to tell you is that it sounds really difficult, but it isn't. In my case, what I can tell you is this. Technically, you know, when you go for, when you make the decision to have the surgery and you get it booked, they do give you instructions. You go for like a pre-operation appointment, and they give you instructions as to what the surgery is going to be like, and immediately afterwards, what happens the first few moments after the surgery, what happens a few days after the surgery, and what type of care you need to take to make sure that you do for yourself after the surgery, immediately after the surgery. So one of the things you have to keep in mind is that you are going to spend time not talking at all. When I say not talking, I really mean nothing. You can't even say yes or no. Nothing. You can't even pretend that you're talking. You cannot whisper. Whispering is really bad. But you can't use your voice in any way, shape, or form. You can't cough. One of the questions I had is, what happens if you snore? But you have to try not to use your voice at all. In my case, I wasn't really afraid of not talking. Not talking wasn't really, I was afraid of it. Like, I felt, how's it gonna feel like not talking? But to be honest with you, that was the easiest part because you can control it. You can control if you don't talk. In my case, I have this office and I love to write, so I did a lot of writing those days. I have a book in the making, and I wrote a good half of my book, of my first draft, during those days, that week that I wasn't talking. So the first 3 days after your surgery is complete silence. You're not supposed to say anything at all whatsoever. You can't cough. You can't, like I said, you can't use your voice at all. You have to try to find ways for that to happen. I would say thank God for texting. I kept my phone close to me at all times. My husband was working from home. He took off the first day and then he was working from home. And he made sure that he kept his phone right by him. So if I needed anything, he would get it for me, but most of the time I was able to get whatever I needed for myself, because you're really not, all you have to do is like not talk, but you can move around. You can do a lot of things for yourself. So if you just avoid talking and you use your phone to communicate with people, you just make sure that you tell people, like, you know, when they ask you questions, they have to be simple questions, because otherwise you're going to be typing up a storm. If that doesn't bother you, that's okay. But for me, I just try to keep it simple. I would say, well, that answer requires a lot and I can answer you later. But I could answer like in very simple terms. And you will be surprised like how many things you think are simple answers, but they really aren't. They're much more involved questions than you, you know, feel like you want to answer. So you could just tell people that's an involved question, but I'm just going to answer the best way I can while I'm typing, because you cannot leave voice messages at all. So all you can use your phone for is for typing. Email is great. So whoever can email you, like email was great for me. So I emailed a lot. So the first few days I typed a lot on my phone and I did a lot of emails, especially those first 3 days, because your first 3 days, you cannot talk at all. After the 3 days go by, you can talk, but very, very, very little. Like, you can say yes, you can say no, but you have to be very, very measured. And in my case, I think I didn't talk at all for like 5 days. Day six or seven, I started to say 2 or 3 words. I think maybe I said 10 words in the entire day, but that was it. And then by day eight, I already had my appointment with my doctor, my post-op appointment, so they could tell me where the healing was at that point. So by day eight, when I went to see my surgeon, they told me that I was healing very nicely, but they still could feel like, because I tried to use my voice in a very forceful way, that it would be a good idea for me to go to speech therapy. And let me tell you something. One piece of advice that I can give you is try to go to speech therapy. And when I say speech therapy, I would say someone that specializes in vocal, in not just in any speech therapy, but a vocologist, someone that specializes in singing and in talking and vocal issues, in dealing with people who have gone through the same issue as you are. In my case, I didn't get to see my vocologist for like 2 weeks after my post-op appointment with my surgeon. And I only wish I had seen her before, but you know, like sometimes you don't get to make these decisions because the doctors write referrals. And when they wrote me the referral, it was too late. It was after my surgery. But it would have been amazing to see her way before my appointment. It would have made a tremendous difference, I feel, not only for the surgery, but for the days after surgery, because I would have had a much better plan of what to do afterwards. So my advice to you is if you are going, if you're thinking about making, if I'm making this decision about having surgery, do go see a vocologist. I could leave the recommendation for mine. Mine is New York based, but she does appointments through Skype and Zoom. So you can see her basically from anywhere in the country, anywhere in the world, if you want, because she can see you virtually. And the visits are just the same. All my visits were virtual. And she helped me just the same. So don't be taken aback by this. Use this as a resource. And I have to clarify, I'm making this recommendation. I'm not getting paid or I'm not getting sponsored. I'm not getting anything out of this. I'm just making this recommendation because I really loved her. Her name is Karen Sussman. And like I said, I'm going to leave the recommendation here. But I can tell you other things that can help you. One of the things that my doctor didn't tell me, but I found out, have a vaporizer, okay? Or a humidifier in your room, because that really helps. If you feel like you want to cough, you just breathe in the air and it really helps you. It really keeps you hydrated. The other thing is drink lots of water. Drinking water really keeps you hydrated and it really helps you. And if you feel like you're going to cough, That really helps you a lot. I did something that later I found out wasn't the best thing, but I kept some like cough lozenges. Mine were lemon with some menthol, but menthol is not really good for you because it's drying. So if you can find anything else, even if it's just any regular candy that helps you not cough, then use that. The doctor did give me medication for afterwards that helped with coughing, but it was like it would knock me out. And I really wanted to make use of the time that I had not talking to anybody because I really wanted to write. And I, to be honest with you, kind of enjoyed it. I spent my life talking to people and I use my voice a lot. So getting a break from not using my voice, my voice was kind of thanking me. My vocal cords, I felt, were thanking me. It's like if you go for like this really rigorous exercise and then the next day you feel like you really need that rest. Well, my vocal cords really felt like they needed the rest. And not talking for that long, like my voice was like thanking me. I felt like my vocal cords were saying, thank you so much. We really needed that break. So I hope this is really useful for you. I'm going to talk a little more about speech therapy in my next video, but I hope this helps you make a decision. Like I said, if I had to sum this up in a nutshell, I would say to you, it really isn't that bad. It sounds like it's terrible. I know for some people it was 2 and 3 weeks with no talking, especially if you're a singer. But it goes by fast. And you kind of get used to it in a way. And you can do so many other things that you wouldn't do otherwise. Like if you like writing, it's a godsend because you're going to do so much writing. So I don't think it was that much of an issue. And if that was the only reason that was keeping you back from doing this, I would say go for it. It's really not that bad. Okay, I hope that helps you. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a wonderful weekend. Bye.